today in the livestock market. Cattle was firm. That strength in futures heading into the holiday has helped the market quite a bit, really offering some underpinning support of the futures, even though we're still in that same channel. This 4th of July should offer a little bit of demand growth, more so than we normally would see historically. But there is some concerns that will it be able to sustain throughout the summer? That's going to be a real question that has to be answered as we go forward. Now, feeders today were mixed. They spent a lot of the day lower, but were able to come back somewhat. Interestingly enough, when we're looking at the beef product, the grains have rallied an awful lot. And you would have thought that that might have put some pressure on the beef market or on all livestock, and it really hasn't done that. But there is some concerns about the fallout from the COVID resurgence, and disruption in the food service demand is going to be a real issue, and it's going to have an impact definitely on the beef market right now. And I think that that's where traders are starting to just kind of position themselves to figure out just which way this market is going to go. I think that the numbers will tell as we see it. And after the holiday, I think that we can get a little bit better idea about where we are going forward. Now, hogs are a little bit different story today. They were higher. The market support is building in the complex. Now that the second quarter is out of the way, the traders just see that perhaps the bottom is in. They're pretty confident that that's the case, but they're cautiously optimistic that there's going to be continued building in the market. They still haven't filled that gap that was created when the market dropped on Friday. So that's going to be the first thing to try to cover before the holiday. So we've got a lot to do before 4th of July comes.